Hello students, welcome to my channel Engineers Academy. Let's solve this problem. In this problem we are given that if F1 equals to 300 Newton and this theta is 10 degrees, we are required to determine the magnitude and direction measured counterclockwise from the positive x dash axis of the resultant force acting on the bracket, right? So first we have to find the resultant of F1, F2 and F3, and then we have to find the angle of the resultant with this x dash axis, right? And that angle need to be measured in the counterclockwise direction, right? So I will write that F1 magnitude is given, this is 300 Newton, right? And this theta is 10 degrees, right? So let me remove this x dash axis for now, right? So if this theta is 10 degrees, then this means that this F1 force is making 60 plus 10 degrees with the y axis, right? So this means that F1 force is making 70 degrees with the y axis, right? So we can write that this angle is 70 degrees, right? This is 60 plus 10 degrees, right? So this is 70 degree angle of F1 with the positive y axis, right? So to find the resultant, we have to find the Rx component of the resultant, and the Rx component of the resultant will be equal to the summation of all the components along the x direction, right? So now if we resolve F1 into its components, right, so it will have one component which will be acting in this direction, right? F1 will have one component like this, and it will be the cos component, right? And similarly F1 will have one another component which will be acting like this, right? Parallel to the x-axis, right? So this component, let's say that this is f1y, right? And this is f1x. So f1x is the sine component if this is 70 degrees, right? So we can write that this is f1 sine of 70 degrees, and f1 magnitude is 300. So we can write that f1x is 300 sine of 70 degrees. And similarly, f1y, I can write that f1y is 300 cos of 70 degrees, right? Similarly, if I resolve this F3 force into its components, right, so we will have one component in this direction like this, right, and we will have one another component which will be acting in this direction like this, right? And if we consider this theta, so then we have to consider this theta, right? We are given this triangle, right? So let's say that we are considering this angle alpha, let's say. So then this will be f3x, and this component, right, and it is acting in the negative x direction. So f3x will be equal to, so this will be 180 cos of alpha, right? And we can write that this is 180, and cos of alpha from this triangle is base divided by hypotenuse, right? So this will be 12 divided by 13, right? And similarly this will be f3y, and from this triangle we can write that f3y is this will be the sine component. We can write that this is 180 sine of alpha, right? So we can write that this is 180, and sine of alpha from this triangle is perpendicular divided by hypotenuse, right? So we can write that this is 5 divided by 13, right? And now if we look into this F2 force, so this F2 force is only acting in the y direction. So this means that F2x is 0, right? We can write that the component of F2 along the x-axis is 0, since the whole F2 force is acting in the positive y direction. And similarly, we can write that F2y will be equal to F2, right? Since the whole F2 is acting in the positive y direction, so this will be equal to 200 newtons, right? So now if you want to find the Rx component, so this is equal to the summation of all the components along x-axis, right? So we can write that this will be equal to f1x plus f2x and plus f3x, right? So f1x is 300 sine of 70, so I will write that this is 300 sine of 70 degrees plus f2x. f2x is 0, right? So this is 0 plus f3x. So f3x is this thing, right? 180. We can write that this is 180, and remember that this f3x is acting in the negative x direction, so we have to write the negative sign with it, right? Since we are considering that this is our positive direction, right? So this is minus 180 into 12 divided by 13, right? Or we can remove this bracket, right? So we can multiply this positive with negative, so this will become negative, right? So we can write it directly like this, right? So this will give us the Rx component of the resultant of these three forces, right? So let me calculate it. So this is 300 sine of 70 plus 0 minus 180 into 12 divided by 13. So this comes out to be 115.75, right? So I will write 115.75 newtons, right? Similarly, if you want to find the Ry component, right? So Ry will be equal to the summation of all components in the positive y, in the y direction, and we will say that this is our positive direction, right? So this will be equal to F1y plus F2y plus F3y, and we can write that Ry will be equal to, so F1y, this is F1y, so F1y we have written here that it is 300 cos of 70 degrees, right? So we can write that this is 300 cos of 70 degrees plus F2y, so F2y is equal to F2, which is 200, so we will write 200 plus F3y, so F3y is 180 into 5 divided by 13. And all of these are acting in the positive y direction. If you look into this, F1y is acting in the positive y direction, F2 is acting in the positive y direction, and F3 is acting in the positive y direction, right? So this will give us the Ry magnitude. So let me calculate it. 300 cos of 70 plus 200 plus 180 into 5 divided by 13. So this is equal to 371.84, right? So 371.84 newton. So now to find the resultant magnitude, we can write that R will be equal to Rx square plus Ry square, and we will take the square root, right? So before finding the magnitude, let me draw the resultant, right? So let me draw the resultant, right, on this diagram. So let's say that this is our positive x and positive y direction, and our x is positive, our y is positive, right? So we can write that, let's say that this is the Rx component, which is 115. Let's say this is Rx, and let's say that this is Ry, right? So by head to tail rule, if we add Rx with Ry by head to tail rule, so it must give us the resultant, right, from the tail of our x to the head of our y, right? This is our y, and this is the resultant, right? But in the problem, we are required to find the angle of the resultant measured counterclockwise from the positive x dash axis, right? So first, let me find this angle. Let's say that this angle is alpha, right? So if we apply tan alpha, right, let me write that tan alpha will be equal to Ry divided by Rx, right? And Ry is known, which is 371.84 divided by 115.75, right? And if we take tan inverse, so this will give us that phi angle, right? So tan inverse 371.84 divided by 115.75. So tan inverse 371.84 divided by 115.75. So the angle is 72.71, right? So the phi angle is 72.71 degrees, right? So let me show that x dash axis is, right? So as we can see that this x dash axis is like this whole angle is, this theta is 10 degrees, right? This whole angle is 70 degrees, and this angle, this x dash is making how much angle? So the x dash is making 60 degree with the positive y axis, is right? So this whole angle is 90 degrees. So this means that this purple angle is how much? So this will be 90 minus 60, right? So this is 30 degrees. So this means that if we draw the x dash axis is here, so the x dash axis is making 30 degrees with the positive x axis, right? From here, we know that this x dash axis is, let me say that this is x dash axis. So this x dash axis is making 30 degrees, right? This angle is 30, right? And we have found this phi angle is 72.71. Let me remove this ry and rx, right? So this angle is 30 degrees. And this phi angle, this whole angle is how much? So this is 72.71. Let me write that this is 72.71 degrees. So we, in the problem, we are required to find this angle, the angle of the resultant with the x dash axis is measured in the counterclockwise direction. So we have to find this angle, right? So let's say that this angle is beta, right? So now we can say that this alpha angle is equal to beta plus 30 degrees, right? And we are required to find beta angle. So then beta angle is alpha minus 30 degrees. So alpha is known, right? So we can write that beta is 72.71 minus 30 degrees. So 72.71 minus 30 is 42.71 degrees, right? So this means that the beta angle is 42.71 degrees, right? And this beta angle is the angle of the resultant from the x dash axis, and this angle is measured in the counterclockwise direction from the x dash axis, right? And if we want to find the resultant, we can use this equation, right? So we can find it directly by using calculator, right? So rx square, the resultant magnitude is rx square. So rx is 115.75 square plus ry. Ry is 371.84 squared, right? So this will give us the resultant magnitude, and the resultant magnitude is 389.44, right? So the resultant magnitude is 389.44 newtons, right? So this is the solution of this particular problem.